At Ubisoft, we are constantly working to develop new technologies that will generate ever more realistic worlds, improve the player experience, as well as provide the best tools to our creators. We want to introduce you to three emerging technologies that we draw upon at Ubisoft to continue creating the future of gaming. Look at these two images from Watch Dogs Legion. Do you see the difference? How one of them is more realistic than the other? Developers achieve this level of detail thanks to ray tracing. Stephanie Brenham, team lead programmer at Ubisoft Toronto, tells us what ray tracing is and how it works.
Ray tracing is about simulating how light actually moves in our world. It's not just about a set piece where you're looking at a static shot. It's about interacting with the world in real time. The main areas are reflections, shadows, global illumination. These reflections are not just limited by what is in front of the screen. These are things that come from off of the screen and can be crisp as we would expect in a modern urban landscape. In the real world, light from a light source doesn't end in crisp shadows. There's a fall off. There's a rounded shape to these shadows, and that allows extra light to come into the scene. If you have a bright red object sitting next to something white, you're gonna end up seeing a bit of a pink tinge to it because the light interacts with everything that it's touching. And this global illumination adds to the warmth of a scene, to the drama of the scene, to making it immersive.
In game development, teams are not only working on delivering more realistic worlds, but also on creating innovative experiences and delivering them to players in new ways. That's where cloud technology can play a big part. Jimmy Boulian from Ubisoft Saguenay explains how cloud streaming works to play games on any device, and the promise of cloud gaming for the future of game experiences.
Playing a game in streaming is the same as having a virtual console. So instead of having those devices at home, they are running into the cloud. And through the internet, it's ready to play. The main advantage is to have access to it from anywhere, as long as I have a stable network connection, is to make sure that the latency, so the time between you and the game, is as short as possible. So the other advantage is that I can play recent games right away without the need to install it or to upgrade. In the future, since the game is running into the cloud, we'll go more and more into cloud gaming. We're gonna move from streaming to cloud gaming. Game developer can use this extra power and resources to extend the game or improve the game experience. So it means more physics, more AI, more non-playing character, the size of the world, or even the number of players that can be connected at the same time in the same world. The best things to do is to try it out. It's a good opportunity to go through our latest games on Stadia, Luna, Microsoft Cloud, and GeForce Now. So enjoy, and it's just the beginning.
Technology is at the service of Ubisoft's creators. We have R&D teams that are working on cutting-edge tools to improve our production pipelines. Abbasine Surufangbemi, data scientist at Ubisoft La Forge, introduces us to one of those prototypes, a machine learning software that can generate 3D animations from 2D videos.
Our project SoBuilder helps us create 3D animation for animals from videos using machine learning. Animals come in different forms and shapes, and they also have different skeleton structures. So to create animation for animals, most of the time are done manually, and it is what we call keyframe animations. Machine learning algorithms are a set of algorithms that are capable of learning different features or patterns from different data we provide them. Using those assets, we try to create a set of synthetic data that we use to train our machine learning models. Once The models are trained. We integrate them into an end-to-end pipeline that we call ZooBuilder, and that takes as input the 2D videos and then generate as output the 3D animations. The process of creating the 3D animation goes like this. Firstly, ZooBuilder tries to identify on each frame of the video the different location or the 2D coordinates of the different joints that constitute the skeleton of the animal. ZooBuilder used that sequence of the 2D coordinates to infer the corresponding 3D coordinates. And it is those 3D coordinates that we use to actually create our 3D animations. Because ZooBuilder is still a prototype, we cannot use it yet in our production. We think ZooBuilder can be used to help animators prototype quickly their animations. Additionally, AI and machine learning models are capable of generating more content than humans are capable of in a short amount of time. And though those content generated by AI are not necessarily perfect, still, they can be a great source of inspiration for our artists.
Want to learn more about our in-house technology and expertise? Visit ubisoft.com/technology.